performing a test of independence. For example, are views on abortion independent of age? A recent poll asked senior citizens and teenagers whether they were pro-life or pro-choice when it comes to abortion issues. The results of the survey are as follows. Test whether an individual's opinion regarding abortion is independent of age at the 5% level of significance. The procedure for conducting a chi-score test of independence is as follows. First, we're going to state the hypotheses. And for the null hypothesis, we're going to assume that the two variables are independent. For the alternative hypothesis, we're going to try to prove that the variables are dependent. Or, in a sense, they're not independent. The second step is to identify the level of significance. In the third step, we're going to compute the test statistic, and it follows a chi-square distribution. So we'll be analyzing the observed counts as well as the expected counts. Where O represents the observed counts, and E represents the expected counts. We'll also have degrees of freedom, which is equal to R minus 1 times C minus 1. R is equal to the number of rows, and C is equal to the number of columns. In the fourth step, we're going to identify the critical values or use technology to compute the p-value. And in the fifth step, we're going to state the decision and the conclusion. Now that we know the procedure, let's apply it to this example. So in step one, we're going to identify our hypotheses. So for the null hypothesis, we're going to state that views regarding abortion and age are independent. So you want to ensure that you identify the two variables when stating the null and alternative hypotheses. And for the alternative hypothesis, we're going to try to prove that the views regarding abortion and age are dependent. In step two, we're going to identify the level of significance. This test was performed at the 5% level of significance. Thus, alpha is equal to 0.05. In the third step, we're going to compute the test statistic, and in order to compute the test statistic, we're first going to identify the observed counts. The observed counts, which can be referred to as the original data collected, can be seen in the contingency table for this example. So for this example, our contingency table is as follows. And you can see that we have the actual counts, the observed data for the senior citizens and the teenagers regarding whether they're pro-life or pro-choice. And so the values of 196, 239, 199, and 249 will be considered our observed counts. Now I'm going to simply write down the observed counts to the side so I can easily identify them later. So again, my observed counts are 196, 199, 239, and 249. Next, I'm going to determine the expected counts for each cell. So in order to determine the expected counts for each cell, you're going to take its row total, so the corresponding row total for that cell, times the corresponding column total, and then divide by the sample size. So the first cell we're going to look at is the one involving 196. And so its corresponding row total is 395. And we're going to multiply it by its corresponding column total of 435. And then divide by the sample size of 883. And once we do the math on that, we get 194.592. And we're going to repeat this process for each cell. And again, these are going to be called our expected counts. And so for our next cell that has 199, we're going to take its row total of 395 times its corresponding column total of 448 and divide by the sample size of 883. And once you do the math on that, you get 200.408. For our third cell that has 239 in it, we're going to take its row total of 488 times its column total of 435 and divide by the sample size of 883. And we get 240.408. And finally, for the last cell, we're going to take its row total of 488 times its column total of 448 and divide by the sample size of 883. And we get a result of 247.592. And so now that we know our observed counts and expected counts, we can plug this into the chi-squared test statistic formula, and the formula is as follows. And so again, we're going to sum the observed counts minus the expected counts, that quantity squared, divided by each respective expected counts. So our first observed count was 196, so we're going to take 196 minus its expected count of 194.592, square that quantity and then divide it by its expected count of 194.592. And don't forget that sigma means sum, so you're going to add these observations together. And finally, when you're all done, you're going to perform correct order of operations, and you'll get a final result of 0.036. Now that we know that the value of the chi-square test statistic is 0.036, we can proceed to step 4, which is determining the critical value. For this example, it follows a chi-square distribution, so we'll be using the chi-square table. It has degrees of freedom equal to the quantity of r minus 1 times c minus 1. And recall, r is the number of rows, and there were 2 rows in this example. And c is the number of columns, and there were 2 columns in this example. So if we plug in 2 for r as well as c, we end up with just simply 1 degree of freedom. And so given the fact that alpha is equal to 0.05 along with 1 degree of freedom, we have a critical value equal to 3.8415. And so if we were to display this visually, our critical value of 3.8415 falls about here, and that's our rejection region, and our test statistic of 0.036 clearly does not fall in the rejection region. And therefore, our decision is to do not reject the null hypothesis. And the conclusion is as follows. There is not sufficient evidence to suggest that views regarding abortion and age are dependent.